Good morning, dear students. In the last class, I have taught you about min-max algorithm and alpha-beta pruning. So in today's class, I am going to teach you about constraint satisfaction problem. Okay? So in this constraint satisfaction problem, each and every state there will be some constraint. You have to solve that particular constraint in order to move to the next level. Okay? So if you see this particular constraint satisfaction problem, this can be explained with the two examples. One is map coloring problem, and the another one example is high order constraint, that is crypt arithmetic problem. So this crypt arithmetic problem I have already taught you in unit 1. Okay, in unit 1 I have already taught you this crypt arithmetic problem, like 1 plus 1 2 send more money. I hope you remember that particular problem. So in this class I am going to teach you about this constraint satisfaction problem with map coloring problem. Okay, since I have covered crypt arithmetic problem in the unit 1, I am going to teach you this crypt arithmetic problem with the map coloring problem. So if you see this crypt arithmetic CSP, that is constraint satisfaction problem, it is are of two types. One is least constraint satisfaction problem and another one is most constraint satisfaction problem, LCSP and MCSP, least constraint satisfaction problem and most constraint satisfaction problem. So what is least constraint satisfaction problem? So when you have a box which has to be colored with three colors, if I use all the three colors, that is red, green, blue, if I use all the colors and I don't have any colors for the future, then you call it as most constraint satisfaction problem. Okay, if you use all the three colors and you don't have any color for the future, then the condition is very tough. I don't have any color safe in my pocket. So you call it as most constraint satisfaction problem. Suppose if you have used only two colors and if you have a color in your pocket, like I have used only red and green and I have still have a color in my pocket to color maybe this side. So I have used green here. So red, green, green. Okay. So I have one color left in my pocket, I have used only two colors, so you call it as least constraints. I am in a secured manner, I have in a safe state, okay? I have a color in my pocket, so you call it as least constraint satisfaction problem. Clear? So constraint satisfaction problem is are of two types, one is least constraint and most constraint. If you have a color in your pocket for your future, you call it as least constraint. If you don't have any color in, for the future purpose, then you call it as most constraint satisfaction problem. So what is the constraint here is, in this map coloring is, when you do the coloring, the neighboring box should not have the same color. So that is the constraint here. So you can see here, I have three boxes. I have colored the first box with green, then red, then green. So the neighboring colors, neighboring boxes are not of the same color. So that is the only constraint that we use in map coloring problem. So I have a graph here. Now for this map, I have to do the color. You are going to help me out. So the this particular portion, I am using the color red. For B portion, I am using the color green. And for this portion D, I am using the color again red. Then this portion, I can use the color green. So I have used only two colors till now. But for this particular box, I have to use the third color blue. Why means? It is neighbor to red, it is neighbor to green also. So I cannot use both red as well as green. I have to give the third color blue here for the state C. Okay. So this is called as map coloring problem. Suppose if you give here red means what happens? It gets conflict with A. So you have to backtrack and you have to use blue here. Okay, so this concept is called as backtracking. When you give a color and if you find a conflict, you have to backtrack, go back to the previous state and you have to choose a different color. So this concept you call it as backtracking in CSP. Okay, so I'll show you how to do the backtracking for this diagram. Backtracking in CSP. So if you see, initially it is empty. So first node which I am coloring is, how many possible colors? 3 possible colors for A. A can be colored with red, it can be colored with blue, or A can be colored with green. Okay, so 3 possible colors: red, green, blue. We are assuming that first I have colored with red. So what is the next possible state? If I have colored A with red, means A is red, then this state blue can be colored with either green, or B can be colored with blue. Okay, so 2 possibilities. So assume that I have chosen B as green color. So what will be the color for this particular C? Okay, so what will be the color for C in this condition? A is red, B is green. Now I am giving C as also red. If I give, what are the possible colors? Since it is green here, I can use red, or I can use blue here. A is red, B is green. Red, green, C is blue. So these are the 2 possibilities. When I give red for C, what happens? A is also red, C is also red, both are neighbors. So contradiction occurs, conflict occurs. So what happens when it gets conflict? You have to backtrack. You have to backtrack, and you have to use the next state for expanding. So you are going to expand this node further. So this is called as backtracking. Okay, so when you find the contradiction, go back and choose the next state. Instead of red, now you are going for blue. Okay, so next, what you are going to do, you are going to expand D and put color for E. Okay, so that you can do it here. Okay, so the process of going back to the previous step and choosing a different color, you call it as backtracking in CSP. So this is also seems to be a very important question. Okay, so if you see this constraint, I was talking about this constraint, right? This constraint is of 3 types. So one is called as unary constraint, then binary, then high order. So there are 3 types of constraint. One is unary constraint, binary constraint, high order constraint. So if you talk about this unary constraint, only one condition is there, then you call it as unary constraint. For example, A is equal to red, so A must be given red color alone. This you call it as unary constraint. What about binary constraint? A must not be equal to B. 2 nodes are involved in this constraint, so you call it as binary constraint. What is high order constraint? The script arithmetic problem. So each and every node has a constraint, so that you call it as, more than one constraint is there, then 2 constraint is there, then you call it as high order constraint. So one constraint available na unary, 2 conditions are available na binary, more than 2 conditions if it is available, then you call it as high order constraint. Okay, so this is about constraint satisfaction problem with map coloring. So even though I have covered this crypt arithmetic problem, just I would like to solve a small example for this crypt arithmetic problem also in this class, so that you will remember that. So one small problem for crypt arithmetic problem. Okay, so I am giving a problem like for this one: 1 + 1 = 2. You have to solve this with a crypt arithmetic problem. So in this crypt arithmetic problem, each variable has to be given an individual number. For example, for E, you are giving 1 means wherever this e is present, you have to assign it with the value 1. So here I have assigned it with 1. So here also we have e, I have assigned it with 1. No other place I have 1 here, okay? So now you can add these two together. So 1 plus 1, I will get the answer as 2. So now O has become being assigned with value 2 here. So wherever this O is present, I have to assign that value with 2. So here O is there, so 2, 2. So now what happens when I add these two together, I will get 4 for T. So now T has become 4. So no other place I have T here, so no issue. I don't need to update the value of T further. Now the left portion is only N. So already 1 is applied, 2 is applied. So now I will assign 3 for N, okay? So N is equal to 3 here. So what happens is I am having 3, 3 for this. Now when I add this, I will get 6 here. So now W has become 6 as well as N has become 3. So now I have solved this particular problem. So each word, each alphabetic letter has a different constraint, different number. So this you call it as constraint satisfaction problem with crypt arithmetic. Okay, so this is a crypt arithmetic problem where each and every alphabetic letters has a condition. Okay, so remember that you have to apply letters from only A to B, A to Z will be used from 0 to 9 also. You should not use 11, 12, 13 and all. You assign the value only between 0 to 9. You remember this. And you can have some carries also. So I will show you how to do a carry with carry. Suppose if I assign a value 5 here instead of 1, if I have a value 5 here, what happens is 5 plus 5, 10. So 0 comes here and 1 will be carried here. Okay. So now what happens is 3 plus 3 plus 1, that is 7. W will become 7. So like this also you can do it. So 5 plus 5, 10, 0 here and 1, 0 here and 1 will be carried out. Now 3 plus 3, 6 plus this 1, now W will become 7. So like this also you can solve with carry. But remember, you have to assign only with values A to Z as well as from 0 to 9. You should not use 11, 12, 20, 22 and all. Okay. So if possible, try to solve this problem from your home. Send more money. Okay. Try to solve this problem as a homework. Okay. So in today's class, I have taught you about constraint satisfaction problem. In the next class, I'll be teaching you about hill climbing. Okay? Thank you.